Our help is in the name of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Again, good morning. And again, happy Father's Day. And so let us begin in the name of the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Lord, bless us with the wisdom to praise you in spirit and in truth, so by following your holy will, we may gain eternal salvation.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment, confess our sins to God in ways that we have failed him and our neighbor in thought, word, deed, and omission, so that we may worthily participate in this holy sacrifice. Please now make an examination of your conscience. Say together the second form of the Confiteor found on page 66. I confess to Almighty God, in the presence of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned through my own fault, in my thoughts, in my words, and what I have done or failed to do. I ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. For your penance, I would ask you to do one kind thing for someone else sometime in the next couple of days. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And may our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me, I absolve you from all of your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
God is our refuge and our strength, an ever-present help in distress. Thus we do not fear, though earth be shaken and mountains quake to the depths of the sea, though its waters rage and foam and mountains totter at its surging. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father,
we worship you,
we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory.
Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty Father, you are the consolation and salvation of those who trust you. The tempests of the world rage about us, and the sea of life often carries us far from you. Speak your word of command, and that the earthly storms may subside, and that we may be guided in peace to the harbor of your kingdom. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for our first reading.
A reading from the book of Job. The Lord addressed Job out of the storm and said, "Who shut within doors of the sea when it burst forth from the womb? When I made the clouds its garment and thick darkness its swaddling bands? When I set limits for it and fastened the bar of its door and said, 'Thus far shall you come, but no farther, and here shall your proud waves be stilled?'" This is the word of the Lord. Our response is, give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting.
Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting.
They who sailed the sea in ships, trading on the deep waters, these saw the works of the Lord and his wonders in the abyss.
Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting.
His command raised up a storm wind, which tossed its waves on high. They mounted up to heaven. They sank to the depths. Their hearts melted away in their plight.
Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting.
They cried to the Lord in their distress. From their straits he rescued them. He hushed the storm to a gentle breeze, and the billows of the sea were stilled.
Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting.
They rejoiced that they were calmed, and he brought them to their desired haven. Let them give thanks to the Lord for his kindness and his wondrous deeds to the children of men.
Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the love of Christ impels us. Once we have come to the conviction that one died for all, therefore all have died. He indeed died for all, so that those who live might no longer live for themselves, but for him who for their sake died and was raised. Consequently, from now on, we regard no one according to the flesh. Even if we once knew Christ according to the flesh, yet now we know him so no longer. So whoever is in Christ is a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, new things have come. This is the word of the Lord. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. A great prophet has risen in our midst. God has visited his people.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. On that day, as the evening drew on, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us cross to the other side." Leaving the crowd, they took Jesus with them in the boat, just as he was, and the other boats were with him. A violent squall came up, and waves were breaking over the boat, so that it was already filling up. Jesus was in the stern, asleep on a cushion. They woke him and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up, rebuked the wind, and said to the sea, "Quiet, be still." The wind ceased, and there was great calm. Then he asked them, "Why are you terrified? Do you not yet have faith?" They were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who is this then, whom even the wind and sea obey?" This is the gospel of the Lord.
"Why are you terrified? Do you not yet have faith?" These words are taken from today's gospel according to St. Mark, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, our gospel today is one of my personal favorites. In fact, at one of my assignments, my confessional, I had this particular scene inside the confessional when Jesus calmed the storm on the sea. And the apostles were so terrified that they were going to drown. And yet Jesus was asleep. Because he knew that everything was going to be okay. Because he knew his Father intimately. And that, my brothers and sisters, is the same faith that you and I are called to have. And it's something that we develop throughout our lives and our lives in Christ. It starts with the seed planted in our baptism. And if we feed it with our relationship with Jesus and let it grow, it's like the mustard seed last week, then it will fill us to the point where nothing will get us away from our belief that no matter what happens, we're going to be okay because Christ is with us. I have recently, as you know, was on vacation on the West Coast. And when you look out at the ocean on a calm day, there's nothing more peaceful, especially when the sun is setting over the water. And you can see the reflection of the sun off the water. But when a storm comes up and the waves start crashing, especially if you happen to be in the water at the time, it's buffeting. Nothing more frightening. Life is like that sometimes too, isn't it? Life can throw us a curve at any moment. It can be a sudden death of a loved one. It can be a sudden loss of income. It can be just about anything. But Jesus promises us, and it shows here that he is there with us. Even Mark's community that he was writing to and included the story in, at the time of about the year 65 or so, they were being persecuted so badly. They were getting beaten, whipped, killed because of their faith in Jesus. And some of them were wondering, why isn't God listening to our prayers? Well, he was. He's with them. And eventually, in his time, it will calm down again. There's an old proverb, I think it's a Chinese proverb, maybe Japanese, but it's somewhere out in Asia, that the bad news is the good times won't last. The good news is the bad times won't last. And that's what Jesus does for us. He keeps us, even though through the tumult, knowing in faith that it will calm. Only we allow our faith to grow to the point where we know that in the depths of our being, through prayer, reception of the sacraments, especially the Eucharist, and just that rock-hard knowledge that he is there for us and will protect us if we stay with him.
May
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Now stand and turn to page 71 and say together the creed that unites us as Christians. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Whoever belongs to Christ is a new creation. Old things have passed away, new things have come. With a longing for this newness, we turn to the Father with our prayers, and our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For Prime Bishop Anthony, Bishop Jerry, all clergy, that they may lead us to a deeper faith in God and a stronger love for others, we praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, that they be inspired by God's Spirit to protect his creation and advance ways to provide food, refuge, and welcome for all, we praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For favorable weather, good growth and yields, and for the health and safety of our farmers and all who work the land, we praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all of those who are ill, especially those on our parish prayer list, that they may trust in God's continuing love for them and experience his healing presence, we praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
The intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. For all fathers living and deceased for whom this Mass is being offered, we praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our beloved dead and those who will die today, that they may enjoy the promised reward of eternal life in heaven, we praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Loving Father, hear and answer all of our prayers, both spoken and unspoken. Increase in us the gift of faith, and with your forgiveness at hand, may we live always anew in the Spirit. We ask this through your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the same Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Save me, O God, for the waters threaten my life.
Thank you.
pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Heavenly Father, through this holy sacrifice, may we become a new creation to work together with your Son for the reconciliation of the world. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, you gave your Son power to heal and perform signs and miracles, to reveal your glory. Recognizing Jesus as Lord of all creation, may we rejoice in him as we obey his word. Therefore, with the angels and archangels, with all the saints and the entire church, we lift our hymn of praise to your glory, repeating unceasingly. Sacrifice of the Mass will continue with Eucharistic Prayer 4, which is found on page 88. Blessed are you, Lord of all majesty and King of eternal glory, for your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. In him your word was made flesh. In him the fullness of your grace was revealed in splendor. In all things he fulfilled your will and glorified your name. He proclaimed your kingdom to us. He broke the power of darkness over us. He took our guilt upon himself. He reconciled us to you and unlocked the new paradise for us. As the way, the truth, and the life, he has revealed your love to us. He humbled himself and became obedient even to death on a cross, and by rising restored our life. The night in which he was betrayed, to undergo that suffering which he himself had chosen, he took bread into his hands and, lifting his eyes to you, Heavenly Father, gave thanks, blessed the bread, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which is given for you. Supper had ended, he took the cup and gave thanks to you. He blessed it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which shall be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you do this, do it in remembrance of me. Together, your death, Lord Jesus, we proclaim, your resurrection we celebrate, your returning glory we adore. Therefore, Father, we remember his saving passion, his glorious resurrection, and his exaltation at your right hand. We await his coming in the fullness of majesty. We here set forth this sign of our faith in him, who offered you the perfect sacrifice and gained for us eternal salvation. Send your Holy Spirit, the giver of life and holiness, upon us and upon these gifts, the bread and wine of eternal life. Together, Holy Spirit, come to us. Fill us with your gift of grace. Take these gifts from our hands, Lord God, as an acceptable sacrifice, through which we offer ourselves to you, so that the bread which we break and the cup which we bless may be a sharing in the body and blood of your Son. May all who receive from your heavenly altar always remain united with you, together with all your saints and chosen ones, the blessed and glorious Virgin Mary, the Mother of our Lord, with your prophets and apostles, with your martyrs and confessors, and with all who stand about your throne in praise and prayer. Bless your church throughout the world, grant it unity and peace. Renew the earth according to your promise. Remember all peoples, and grant that all nations may give you thanks, worshiping and praising your holy name. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen. Page 95. Let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior gave us.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
We have a blessing which we bless. Is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread which we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ?
Because there is one bread, we are in our one body, for we all partake of the one bread.
May the union of divinity and humanity in Jesus Christ bring us sanctification and eternal life.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace. My peace I give you. Do not look at our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us offer to one another a sign of Christ's peace. Say together the First Communion prayer on page 97. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit. Your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free me from all my sins and from every evil. Be faithful to your teaching and never let me be parted from you. I will take the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed.
May the body of Christ bring me to everlasting. Blood of Christ bring me to everlasting life. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the table of the Lord. Those who, for personal reasons, cannot receive or who are watching us online, please join us now in the act of spiritual communion. Most loving Jesus, I adore you in the most blessed sacrament in which you are truly present. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart and heal my soul. I embrace you and unite myself with you, and I never be separated from you. Flame my heart with the fire of your love. Lord and Savior, amen. but the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the Lord's glory as water covers the sea.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, through this holy Eucharist, reassure us in all times of fear that in our passage through life, you are ever present to protect and save us. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever. The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Please join me now in the prayer of St. Michael. Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to you, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen.
Please join me now in a prayer for peace in our world, country, state, and localities with the prayer of St. Francis.
Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O Divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, thank you so much for joining us today for Holy Mass. We will resume our in-person and live-stream weekday masses starting tomorrow through Thursday. And we pray that you have a great day, a great week, and always remember to stay in a state of